Now, fair gameplay has always been a requirement of multiplayer games, although it didn't always start that way. See, back in the early 90s, video game players were actually able to tweak some of their parameters to get an unfair advantage. Quake players, for example, would actually lower their resolution on their graphics card to the lowest quality setting, reducing the amount of processing time required to process a frame, so they would actually get higher frame rates. Another good example that I'm not really, you know, bitter about or anything, was my Quake clan actually lost the last round of a very expensive tournament because all of us were on dial-up while the other team was all on DSL. Again, this was back before cable modems. Again, not that I'm bitter about that. The point is that unfair gameplay makes it bad for everyone and then makes bitter people get bald. Since then, multiplayer games have actually done a lot to reduce this kind of cheating and unfair advantage, but it is something that we had to worry about inside of Grits. See, if you're actually using mouse controls, you have a lot more degrees of freedom because there's more resolution to it than someone who's playing on a four-pad keyboard. We decided to actually attack this for Grits because some of us were bitter about losing unfair games in the past, and actually lock the mouse to the same directional output that you get from a keyboard, ensuring that both players actually have a same and fair chance to play. Now, your designer should mostly take care of this, but if you're one of those types who likes design and program, make sure you start from the beginning worrying about fair gameplay, or you could create someone like this.